The adrenal cortex has three layers, as we discussed in the last section, and the outermost layer is the zona glomerulosa. I think they thought originally that it looked like kind of like the kidney, and so they thought it looked like glomeruli. So anyway, that's not exactly important, but here it is. This doesn't really look like a kidney. The zona glomerulosa is the outermost layer, and it is responsible for secreting mineral corticoids. So mineral corticoids do just what you might think they do. They control your minerals, or and so they're related to water balance. The hormone associated with this layer is called aldosterone. Aldosterone is secreted, and it acts on the kidney, and it then encourages the retention of sodium by the kidney, and it also encourages secretion of potassium. So it helps you keep your sodium, get rid of your potassium, and therefore kind of help it. That's one of the mechanisms by which the kidney maintains, helps you maintain your fluid balance. The next layer in is the zona fasciculata here. And the zona fasciculata makes glucocorticoids. And glucocorticoids are responsible, just like they sound, for managing sugar or glucose. So the two hormones that are secreted by this layer include cortisol and corticosterone. These will elevate your levels of blood glucose, and they will stimulate other parts of your body to metabolize proteins and lipids and turn them into sugars. The innermost layer of the adrenal cortex is the zona reticularis. The zona reticularis is responsible for creating and secreting gonadocorticoids. These are hormones that are going to be transferred to the gonads, the ovaries or the testes, for further processing. The zona reticularis secretes androgens, and these androgens are then converted to testosterone by the testes or estrogen by the ovaries. So those are the three major layers, and the hormone products of each of the cortical layers of the adrenal gland. In summary, what I'd like you to know is which hypothalamic releasing hormone eventually influences the adrenal gland, which of the pituitary stimulating hormones directly influences the adrenal gland, what are the subdivisions of the adrenal gland, and when you're talking about the adrenal cortex, what are the named layers and what hormones do they produce? And then what are the actions of these adrenal cortical hormones? If you understand all of these things, then you're going to be ready for the assessment.